were signed and takes 29 years to finish the zodiac, when he comes to each one of us at present in Scorpio who are getting real intense effect to account for your karma. So he can bring expenses, he can bring humiliation, he can bring loss of power, but he can also give you those things. So it's not always negative, but this role is very important, and I've just been coming from some of the planetary temples, and in all the planetary temples, Saturn is very important. They call him Shanishcharaya, means the god Shani, or Acharya Shani. So great person, because people are aware, and the biggest temple of all is Saturn. So when you see the temples, you see the biggest, even bigger than the sun. Sun is quite small, little, but Saturn is a huge temple because people are aware of the karma they have to deal with. So astrologically, we can see when is the time, intense time, for you to repay your karma. But not without looking at your chart, you can have this attitude that this life, why we are born in this life, is so that we can perfect ourselves. This morning somebody asked this question, that why are we born? If Lord Krishna was here before creation, why did he make creation? The whole idea of creation is so that the human beings can improve themselves. In that other level of consciousness, there is only one level. So there is no ability to improve or to rise above any energy. So in order to improve yourself, you come down to earth. Therefore, we all, as spiritual aspirants, we welcome Saturn. We are not worried about Saturn. We welcome him because he's giving us issues which we created. So it's time to pay back. Only thing is, if you understand it is, then you have an easier energy for it. Generally, Saturn's color is black, and his day is Saturday. So, on Saturday, usually it's good to do spiritual things. It's not a good day to get married. It's not a good day to party. But these days, everything is lopsided. You know, Saturday, we have a weekend. Usually Saturn's day is for fasting, for spiritual things, for self-realization. So on Saturday it's a good idea to do your work, not to take a day off on Saturday. It's a good idea to give charity, to do karma yoga, seva, to look after people, voluntary work, any of those things, good deeds you want to do. It's not always a great day for partying, for, of course, you know, we have to have fun as well. Venus represents, Moon actually is the most fun-loving planet. I explained to you yesterday, Moon has 27 wives, 27 different interests. He doesn't want to settle down. So Moon is the most fun-loving planet. But on Saturday, you have to have the awareness. And in India, sometimes people come and they ask for money, and they have a little container with oil, and you give coins to Saturn. Saturn represents iron as well. So we are in iron age. So he's very important to us because we feel his impact a lot. But what is the way to counter Saturn is to study, to selfless service for the old and the poor. That is a very good remedy. You cannot spend your money after a Saturn crisis. You have to give back to society. Something which is Swamiji doing a lot, cleanliness, giving back to society. Those things are the things that you can do the remedy for Saturn. So, looking at Shani, often also he deals with depression. And depression and anger, people tend to think of Mars as angry. But Mars is angry as I'm angry and I've forgotten it tomorrow. Shani's anger is slow burning, depressive anger, which takes you down. So people who have depression or they feel that kind of frustration or anger that is represented by Saturn. So in order to cure that, yoga is a very good thing. In fact, that is the premium remedy for Saturn. Because you are doing something, the path of yoga, which means the spiritual path, but also the asana, pranayama, balancing the energy. So Saturn's element is Vayu. Vayu means air. And those of you study Ayurveda, you know the air element of Vata can go everywhere. And it can take a small situation and make it very big. So this is something that Saturn can do. He can create fear, anxiety, worry. And according to the mythology, when Saturn was born, his father rejected him. So his father is the sun god. And then he went to study with the guru of the gods, which is Jupiter, Brihaspati. And when he went to study with Brihaspati, Brihaspati didn't teach him. He just gave him some very surface information and said, I'm not teaching you anymore. So then Shani reincarnated into this world and he learned from Shukra, which is Venus. So Saturn's guru is Shukracharya. Venus is his guru and Shukracharya gave him the mantra Om Triambaka.
Om Triambakam Yajamahe Sukantim Rushi Vardhanam Purvar Vibhavandhanam Indyo Shri Amrita.
So you see, this mantra is specifically connected with getting rid of your fears and anxieties. And it is a Maha Mantra. So this morning we learned the Hare Rama, that is another Maha Mantra. There are very few Maha Mantras and you've been learning a lot of mantras. It's very important to understand that Maha Mantra is without any fault. You cannot make a mistake chanting a Maha Mantra. It has a blessing. There are many mantras that you can learn from people that are not properly trained. Or you can mess up your energy because mantra, man means mind, tra means to protect. So mantra is protecting your mind, so protecting your mood. Saturn is troubling it. So whenever you are in any form of anxiety, you can chant Maha Mrityunjaya mantra, moksha mantra. I like to think of it as moksha mantra because it helps you to calm down. And it is, you can chant it once, 3 times, 12 times, 108 times. You can ask, you can do it yourself longer, or you can get a priest to do it for 120